just so glad to be here. Thank you so much. My goodness, what a nice welcome. I've been trying to get here to see you folks for years and years, and it's about time I got here, and I am so, I guess you could say that I'm coming out tonight. Well, I'm coming out to present a special award, the Stephen F. Kolzak Award, to my friend Bob Greenblatt. Where is Bob? Oh, great, there you are. Anyway, Bob and I, a lot of you may not know this, but we have quite a few things in common. We're both, well, we do. We're lucky enough to have had the opportunity to work very closely together on 9 to 5, the musical. Yeah. And, of course, we both have a couple of Golden Globe awards. Of course, I do carry mine around with me. I was watching Kristen out here. She was pulling that handkerchief out of there. I think I got a couple of pillows in mine. Seriously, though, as an openly gay producer and executive in Hollywood, Bob has brought so many diverse, multidimensional LGBT characters into homes all across America. Now, I think most of you here tonight know many of these characters from shows like 6 Feet Under, one of my favorites, Nurse Jackie, United States of Tara, The L Word, Queer as Folk, Shameless, and of course there's many more, and I'm sure that most of you, like me, are a big fan of Bob's productions, and of course, I bet you'd be surprised to just know how many things he's got his hands in. Would you like to take a, I didn't mean that. Or I'd have said hands on. How about we take a look at some of those things? Want to? How about? Of course, I know Bob pretty well, and aside from the fact that he works harder than anybody I know and cares more about the people he works with than anybody I know, but he's never been afraid to push the envelope or stand behind things that can make a difference in this world. And of course, I know a little something about what it means to march to the beat of your own drum, because for many years I've enjoyed such goodwill from all kinds of folks, gay and straight. I thank you for that too. Because I really do think that I stand for being proud of who you are and not worrying a lick about what other people think. Really, and I feel fortunate that I've never had to be anything other than myself. And I know Bob has lived his life in exactly the very same way. But we both know that there are many gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender people who are afraid to live this way, in spite of the fact that the world seems to be moving in a more tolerant and accepting direction, finally, thanks to God. Anyway, I think movies, TV, and music can change the way people think. Now, some of you may remember this, but I wrote and recorded the main title song for Transamerica. I love that movie. And I wanted to write it because I love the message of the movie, that everybody has a right to dignity in their lives. And of course, I also saw the power of the message in a little beady movie we did about secretaries who take control back from the men who disrespect them. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by, it's all taking and no giving, they just use your mind, and they never give you credit, it's enough to drive you crazy if you let it cut. speaking of, I saw down here at the table, I see Meg Megan Hilty, who played Dora Lee in 9 to 5, my part. Hi, Megan. And there's Allison Janney, who played Lily Tomlin's part in the movie. Did great. Well, good to see you girls. Maybe I'll get to see you later. But anyway, I am so proud of Bob because he's always used his position in the entertainment business to push back the barriers that work against dignity of gay men and women. In fact, I think he probably does this better than anybody else working in television right now. And that's why I wanted to be here tonight to honor him along with all of you. My friend Bob is one of a kind. In a town that eats loyalty for breakfast, his closest friends remain his high school pals, and I know most of them, great folks. And he breaks the mold of the nice guy finishing last, and he definitely has got to be the only Catholic Robert Greenblatt in the world. Oh, I was surprised to hear that. And on a personal note, I happen to know that he has a sweet tooth that's going to be his downfall, because when we were doing the 9 to 5 musical, I made all this peanut butter fudge, and Lord, he ate till I thought he was going to kill himself. But I was glad to do it, and I am so proud tonight to present him the Stephen F. Kolzak Award. So, Bob, come on up here and get a big old hug from me and get your award.
Thank you all so very much, and thanks, Dolly. I am so honored that, you know, you came all the way out here to Los Angeles to present me with this award. She literally landed about an hour ago, and as soon as the show is over, she's on a plane to London. So, like, that kind of friendship is truly amazing. You know, Dolly, we've all loved you for so many years because of the goodness that comes through everything you do, from your charity work to your incredible talent as an artist. For those of you who haven't had the privilege to know Dolly as I have, I will tell you that there isn't a more genuine, generous, or good-hearted person in the world. Working on 9 to 5 with her and Allison Janney and Megan Hilty, who are both here tonight, was a pure joy for me. And I can personally attest to the fact that the fudge Dolly would bring us in the darkest days of our tech rehearsals, which she made herself, I might add, was truly incredible. As to the Stephen Kolzak Award, I'm very grateful to everyone at GLAAD for thinking of me for this honor. As a gay kid growing up in conservative Rockford, Illinois, the world looked pretty straight. A big part of that, aside from some Catholic guilt and a lot of Midwestern denial, had to do with the fact that gay people just didn't exist on television or in the movies. Unless, of course, you counted Charles Nelson Reilly or Liberace, which I did. But I remember a couple of exceptions to this that somehow managed to slip through the cracks. They made a very strong impression on me and inspired me to push the boundaries when I became an executive and producer. Number one, Medical Center. Some of you probably remember this show on CBS in the early 70s, starring a very fetching Chad Everett as Dr. Joe Gannon. I'm dating myself, but I'll never forget a two-part story in 1975 about a doctor who decides, after much agonizing, to undergo sexual reassignment surgery. The most riveting moment comes at the end when he's finally revealed as a woman. What's even more remarkable is that this character was played by guest star Robert Reed, who we all know is Mr. Brady from the Brady Bunch, and we all know he also came out many years later. I can only imagine what was going through the mind of a closeted gay man playing this character. It must also have taken a lot of courage on the part of the producers and the network, and network president Fred Silverman, for embracing this story in the first place. Now, 35 years later, it's a little troubling to think that transgender storylines on broadcast television are very few and far between. The other groundbreaking series that comes to mind for me is Dynasty. This, of course, was the hit primetime soap produced by the legendary Aaron Spelling in the 80s. Remember those big cat fights in the pool between Joan Collins and Linda Evans? Always wearing those enormous shoulder pads? It actually reminds me a little bit of Bonnie Hammer and Lauren Zelaznik. No, I'm just kidding. They don't wear shoulder pads. What's really memorable about Dynasty is the character of Stephen Carrington, who in 1981 was a defiantly proud gay man on a primetime series trying to deal with his homophobic father. I think this had great impact because it wasn't just a one-shot guest star, but a regular gay character week in and week out on one of the biggest series on television. 10 years later, I found myself working with Aaron Spelling on 90210 and Melrose Place. And for all the young people in the back of the room, I'm talking about the original 90210 and Melrose Place. The ones that people actually watched. Oh, okay. It's okay. I'm not sure if you're applauding for or against that, but that's all right. I will always give Aaron credit for wanting to push the envelope, and he encouraged Darren Star to include an openly gay character named Matt Fielding in the Melrose cast. I will also never forget the gay kiss that almost never happened. In one episode, Matt had a date that ended in a kiss. Now, back in 1994, an innocent gay kiss was a big problem on network television, so Fox asked Darren to remove it. Now, to his credit, Darren told them if they wanted it out, they'd have to remove it themselves. And they did. In the version that aired, as the two men lean in to kiss, just before their lips meet, you cut away to another character looking at them through a window, and the kiss never happens on screen. It was a cowardly thing for the network to do, and I regret not having enough clout at the time to be able to prevent it. But I'm really proud that GLAAD, always on the case, criticized the network very vocally at the time and took out a full-page ad in Variety that read, "Fox, censorship is un-American. Don't censor the creative community and don't censor our lives." Very smart of GLAAD not to make it a gay issue. I think it was very smart of GLAAD not to make it a gay issue, but rather one of equality. I'm happy to say that we've moved beyond the shock of two gay men almost kissing. Or as in 30-something in 1991, dozens of advertisers pulling out of an episode that showed two men just sitting next to each other in bed. Thank God for an early frost in 1985. And Susan Harris casting Billy Crystal as an openly gay man on Soap. Or even Tony Randall in Love, Sydney. Now I know I'm really losing the young people here, right? These characters opened the door for Lesbians on Friends and Ellen to come out, never mind that ABC canceled her show shortly thereafter. HBO encouraged us to play up the gay relationship of Keith and David in 6 Feet Under, and Alan Ball just wrote a very relatable couple that happened to be gay. Showtime made a big impact with proud out shows like The L Word and Queer as Folk, which featured many courageous actors such as Robert Gant, who's in the audience tonight, Will and Grace pushed the envelope even further as the first network show where two of the most prominent characters were gay. And of course, we will always love Sean Hayes for his fearless portrayal of Jack McFarland. Today we have Brothers and Sisters, where two men kissing is all but routine. We have Glee, which is the poster child for gay acceptance. Not to mention Barbra Streisand worship. And we have, of course, Modern Family, with a committed gay couple that redefines what the word family means. I'm proud of my part in advancing the cause. I love my friends at Nurse Jackie, creators Linda Wallum and Liz Brixius, who are here tonight. And of course, Stephen Wallum, who plays Thor. I'm pleased to be associated with so many Showtime shows where all kinds of diverse characters just happen to live. And right now, I'm happy to say that we've got several pilots in production at NBC just crawling with gays and lesbians. In fact, We're making a drama pilot about the ups and downs of putting on a Broadway musical, and if that's not gay, I don't know what is. I actually tried to cast Sean Hayes in that show, but no, he has to play Curly? Larry in The Three Stooges. Which explains the head shaving, right? I salute all the producers, writers, network executives, and actors who took on the issue and broke new ground way before I did, and who continue to do it today. Many of you are in the room tonight. I share this award with you. While we still have a long way to go, we have made great strides both politically and in our media. May that not only continue, but increase in velocity, because we can change the way the world thinks about LGBT people, not to mention how LGBT people think about themselves. Thanks to all my colleagues at NBC who worked so hard on tonight's event and put together that great clip reel. My deepest gratitude to Dolly Parton for being here tonight. And I want to thank Jarrett. Yes, applause for Dolly. I want to thank Amy Poehler and Rashida Jones for doing such an amazing job. You guys are incredible. And of course, Joel McHale, with whom I share height. Thanks to Jarrett Barrio and everybody at GLAAD for you know, this incredible organization. And you know, thanks to all of you in the room tonight for continuing to support this great organization. And that means write a check. Thank you so much.